In this problem, we're looking at the results of an experiment in the lab. So if I start by going down to the data window, I have a bunch of points listed for the acceleration that was measured as a function of time. And then I've used a piece of software to average the acceleration. I can see that it's pretty much a constant value, but there's a little bit of noise in it. And I'm told that the average value there is 1.88 meters per second per second. In other words, the acceleration of the block down this ramp is 1.88 meters per second squared. Then I can go back and look at my experiment, and I see that the ramp is inclined at an angle of 40 degrees. The mass of this block is 550 grams, which I want to express as kilograms, so that's 0.550 kilograms. And we're asked a whole list of questions about the experiment. So starting with part A, we're asked to diagram all the forces acting on the block, including the force of friction and the components of the force of gravity. So the force of gravity, as always, points straight down, and that has a magnitude of mg. And I have room to put the numbers into the diagram here, so that's 0.550 times 9.8, and that gives me 5.39 newtons. Then I want to look at the components of the force of gravity. So I'm going to draw a perpendicular axis real quick. And one component of the force of gravity points perpendicular to the ramp. And we've learned in previous examples that this angle is equal to the angle of incline of the ramp. So that's 40 degrees right there. That means this perpendicular component of the force of gravity is the adjacent side of a right triangle. So I get an mg cosine theta for that. But we already figured out mg is 5.39. So I have 5.39 times the cosine of 40 degrees. And this comes out to 4.129 newtons. The force of gravity also has a component parallel to the ramp surface. That's given by an mg sine theta. That's 5.39 sine 40 degrees. And this comes out to 3.465 newtons. Then I have a normal force acting on this block. It's perpendicular to the surface and exactly canceling that perpendicular component of gravity in order to keep the block moving along the surface instead of accelerating perpendicular to the surface. So that normal force must have a magnitude of 4.129 newtons to balance forces in the perpendicular direction. And then my final force is the force of friction opposing the direction of motion. And we'll call that Fk, and it's given by mu k, the coefficient of kinetic friction, times the normal force. And we don't know what mu k is. That's actually question C. So there's our complete force diagram, and we move on to question B, compute the magnitude of the friction force on the block. And so what we know here is the acceleration of the block that was given by our lab data, and we know the component of the gravitational force pointing down the ramp. So if we apply Newton's second law in the parallel direction, I write down F net equals ma, and if you like, you can specify this is in the parallel direction. And I'm going to refer to down the ramp as the positive direction. So I have a force of 3.465 newtons down the ramp. That was the parallel component of the force of gravity, minus Fk, where Fk is a magnitude of the friction force. So I'm counting this as a negative force because it points up the ramp. That's equal to the mass of the block, which is 0.550 kilograms. Times its acceleration, which was given by the lab data as 1.88 meters per second squared. So I solve for Fk, and this gives me Fk equals 2.431 newtons, just keeping a little extra precision there. And then like I do in all my videos, I just round to three sig figs, so I have 2.43 newtons for the friction force. Then in part C, we're asked to get the kinetic friction coefficient. Well, now that we have the friction force, I can just write down that the kinetic friction force is mu k times the normal force. I have the friction force, I have the normal force, and this allows me to solve for mu k. And I'm going to go back and use my more precise friction force of 2.431. And my normal force was 4.129. And I get a kinetic friction coefficient of 0.589. Finally, there's an extra question at the end that was just designed to force us to go back and think about one-dimensional kinematics. And we're asked to find the time for the block to slide 1 meter. So we know that the block started from rest, and we know the acceleration of the block. So this is a standard one-dimensional kinematics question. I'm going to put the origin at the starting point of the block, and I'm going to refer to down the ramp as the positive direction. So I have an initial position of zero, It started from rest, so my initial velocity is zero. And I'm given the slide distance, that's 1 meter. That's equal to 1/2 times the acceleration times the time squared. T is the only unknown there, and we can quickly solve for that. So I multiply by 2, divide by 1.88, and square root the result. And I come out with a time of 1.03 seconds. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.